Okay, so I got Eva's email about you guys wanting me to go over 4C, so that's what I'm going to talk about right here. So it says a well-known formula states that the surface area of a sphere is 4 times the area enclosed by an equatorial circle. So they use this sort of confusing language, but it's okay, we can dissect that. And I think you already did 4A and 4B, but I just want to make sure we're all clear on what's going on here. So here's my sphere. An equatorial circle is just any circle that goes around an equator of the sphere. So it's also sometimes referred to as a great circle. But that would be something like this, right? This circle, which if the radius of the sphere is capital R, then the area of an equatorial circle would be just pi times capital R squared. And what the statement they're making at the beginning is that the surface area of the entire sphere is 4 times that, so 4 pi R squared. And so in part C, you're actually asked to develop this formula for the surface area of the circle using our surface area, of the sphere rather, using our surface area formula. And it looks like you guys got pretty much all the way there. You're just missing the last step. So I'm going to start from your last step. You can let me know if you need more explanation. So you ended up at simplifying it all the way down to the integral from negative r to r of 2 pi capital R dx. So the thing to keep in mind here, right, is that capital R is a constant, but we are integrating with respect to the variable x. So anytime you take the antiderivative of just some constant, it's just going to end up being the antiderivative will end up being that constant times your variable of integration, right? So just off to the side, I'll give you maybe a more basic example, meaning the integral of 2 dx is 2x. I guess plus c because that one's indefinite, but that's the case here as well. So since we just have this constant 2 pi r, we're going to end up with 2 pi capital R times x, and then we'll just evaluate that from our lower limit to our upper limit, so from negative r to r. So then using the fundamental theorem of calculus part two, I'm just going to plug in my upper limit minus plug in my lower limit. And so that ends up being r plus r. So I have 2 pi r times 2 r, which is 4 pi multiply r times r squared, which was exactly what we were looking to get. And that is the surface area of our sphere. All right, so hopefully that helped. If you need further explanation of part A, B, or you want me to go back further in that integral to setting it up in part C, just let me know and I'm happy to do it.